Devin.
The fuck has happened? Why do you have his car?
Man, a piece of turd, huh? No wonder people are stabbing him in the back.
What happened?
Cheap bastard. You know, I really don't know why you mess around with people like that, Mikey. I mean, really, I don't.
Answer fucking question.
I asked for a fair day's pay after a fair day's work. Then he kind of got a little angry. So I admit, I kind of got a little angry.
Did you kill him?
What kind of fucking animal do you take me for? No, I didn't kill him.
Oh, fuck.
But I did kidnap his wife.
Oh, no. Oh, shit. The fuck did you do?
Oh, I just told you what I just did. Now,
oh, shit.
Unfortunately, I think that we're gonna have to lay low for a little while while, you know, we discuss things with Martin.
Oh, you think?
Why don't you hop in the back? All right, now, Patricia. She already called shotgun.
Now, I know a nice little place we can hang out, you know? It's a very relaxing little spot. A little getaway, if you will. A cabin in the woods. You know what I'm saying.
That's Trio, homie. Yo, get in, Chop.
Gotta train your ass to use the John Chop. That's a big ass pile of shit.
Just trying to hang on until tomorrow.
Casting agent here. Suck my nuts at.
Ah, nuts.
Hey there, sweetheart.
Hi.
What a
Whatever,
joke.
Shithead.
Don't make me call the cops.
Conservative
ass. Screw with her.
Help!
What a good dog.
Get inside, Chop.
Thank you. Ridiculous.
Hey, Molly. I'm outside the studio.
All right. Go over the wall and find the car on the lot.
And then what?
Only the principal actors and stunt people are authorized to go near it. So, you could get in wardrobe and play the part or try something else.
All right.
When you're out of there and clear of studio security, call me.
About.
You need to get on set.
Where the hell is Brandon? Jesus, are you gonna find him? Someone's gotta find him. Where is my movie star? Where is my movie star? Anyone know who this guy
is?
What
are you doing?
This is the new stunt guy. Certainly set up on this guy.
Brandon?
I need to get the fuck out of here!
Studio security are shutting your ass down, wacko!
They ain't gonna be on us for long!
Jesus. Is this an abduction?
Nah! You cool? This button says spikes?
No, I'm not cool! Not at all!
I mean, chill out! I'm just interested in the whip!
What do you mean, the whip? I could buy this car with what I make in a morning.
I think you underestimating the value of this automobile. Or overestimating your own talent.
I think you're underestimating what I get paid.
You get paid a couple million for a morning's work?
Shit, I should sack my agent.
Yeah, shit. Yeah, fools!
Stockholm Syndrome won't work on me, fuckball!
Look, I respect you as an artist and a human being, but I got other priorities.
Give me control of the car, come on! I've been abducted by a crazed man!
Girl, please! Please, I like some of your work, but don't get ahead of yourself!
Get to the side of the road! What's wrong with you? Didn't your parents love you when you were a child?
My dad disappeared. My mom was a crackhead. But that ain't what this about.
My parents loved me so much they put me in a little lazy surprise.
Can't you stop pulling the wheel?
Good for you. I didn't work till I was 10.
You are so going to get the electric chair.
This is more a lethal injection, gas chamber kind of state. But thank you.
People who hurt celebrities are treated worse than pedophiles in prison, and rightly so.
Whatever you say.
You're gonna kill me, aren't you? Another sacrifice to the god of celebrity!
This ain't a sacrifice. It's a carjacking. Now calm the fuck down. Damn, what's this button do?
Stop the car!
If you have the car, bring it to Hayes Auto in South LS. Mr. Weston is marathon training, but he can change his route and meet you there.
Yeah, okay. I got the car and it was missed.
That's fine with us, but your associate, Michael DeSanta, has done some work at the studio and he might not be so happy.
Yeah, whatever.
What kind of shape is the car in? Well, whatever. We plan on refitting the guns to take live ammunition. Do the traffic spike and ejector seat need replacing too?
Both of those is going to need replacing, all right?
Good. One more thing. Mr. Weston's security detail are concerned about a suspicious figure near the garage. Let us know if you see something.
What's wrong with this thing?
You're developing quite the rep there, Slick. Insurance companies hate these kinds of claims. They don't like cats with the inside edge shorting them either. So how'd it go?
Smooth enough, you know, movie people.
You know what the irony is? I'm a major shareholder in that same studio, so what we just did is practically legal. Ha! Practically.
Ooh, shit! Look at this motherfucker. You doing it big, my nigga, on the set. Lamar, what the fuck are you doing here?
Oh, chirped your boy Trevor. It's fucked up when you gotta get your GPS location on your homeboys through a motherfucking speed freak.
True that. Devin Weston, master of the 2-hour female orgasm. What it is, Holmes?
Lamar Davies.
He was just leaving.
Hey, not on my account. You looking for gainful employment, homie?
Hell yeah, I'm always trying to get some motherfucking paper.
Just the type of guy I like to work with. Predictable. Hey, we could bring your boy here in on the last part of the shipment.
Oh, yeah, nigga, that's exactly what you could do. That's exactly
Hell
what you
yeah.
do right
man,
there,
look,
man.
Exactly.
If you want him in, then you get him to boost the rest of the shit you got.
Oh.
Give me my money and I can go on with my motherfucking life.
Oh, no, am I sensing tension here, Slick? He's the spirit,
But you're the brains. Am I wrong? I can see it. Look, I need you on point when we move this stuff out of town.
Yeah, whatever, man. Call me when it's done. And after this, make sure we got our motherfucking check, all right?
Ciao, baby.
It is what it is.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, come here. I'm gonna put you in touch with my legal counsel.
Hey, don't touch me, homie. I don't get down like that.
Yeah, let me tell you how the world works, Slim.
Stay calm, lady. Chill.
Calm! Oh, my God! Ah!
Let's do a big party.
You know, just some rubberneck and shit.
That's old graphic. Thanks, I'll remember that.
Crazy motherfucker Lamar hasn't got you killed yet?
No, not yet.
He must be slacking.
He's always slacking.
He's a fool, bro.
Yeah, sometimes.
Anyway, talking of fools, what would you say if I told you some fools I knew were running a little racing competition? And as luck would have it, they got this really beautiful silver medal with your name on it.
I say go fuck yourself.
Bronze medal then?
Funny, motherfucker. Let's see what we got.
That's just desperate, man.
See you later.
You regret
this shit. Get back here. Relax. You're where you belong.
Are you crazy?
Out the way, fool.
close.
Where you at, man? Your house is empty.
Hey. I had to kind of lay low for a while. Yeah, that nice Mexican we met. Me and T did that job for him, and we fell out.
You gotta be joking.
I wish I was.
So where you at now?
Desert, out by Alamo Sea.
All right, well, I'll hit you if I find anything.
Absolutely. Hey. Trevor's got his wife.
Trevor's got a wife?
No, the Mexican's wife.
What? Shit, I don't know what to say about that one.
Nothing. Nothing to say about that.
Run! Run! I'm back!
Coming, Trevor!
Bring me my coffee, I'm gonna cut your arm off.
Absolutely!
Who the hell's that, your maid?
Oh, business partner. Good guy. Very loyal. Ron, that is Michael. And this is Patricia.
Listen, beautiful. You know, I'm sorry about everything that's happened. And, I can't guarantee no harm's gonna come to you. I might have to chop you up into little pieces before spraying your pulp mess down the drain, but I really hope it doesn't come to that.
I appreciate your honesty. You are a good man. I can see that.
You need your eyes examined, then.
Ron, you miss me?
Yeah, Trevor, a bit, I mean.
How's the fucking business?
I tried.
If you're gonna give me a sob story, I'm gonna rip your fucking throat out and shove a turd down the hole.
It's not a sob story. It's just not quite come good yet. But I heard about something to do with Meriwether.
Those assholes.
Big cache of weapons they got coming in. So I thought you might want to, requisition it.
Fantastic! Let's go!
I'm in.
Whoa, no, not you. Sit down. You're a wanted man. Stay low. And watch her, okay? She's a good lady. Let's go, Ron.
Good to meet you, Michael.
Fucking come on, let's go!
The weapons are coming in by air. We've got a plane over at the airstrip, but...
Great! Let's go!
What are you gonna do?
We're not gonna take out a private army on the ground, Ron. We gotta meet them in the air.
Okay. Well, I knew that you were pissed after the Meriwether heist, giving back the hardware.
That was bullshit!
Right. So I've been monitoring chatter, tapping into Meriwether networks.
Feels good to be back in the company of a professional.
I gotta say, I got it. Now, I was expecting something a little more impressive. The late, great Michael Townley.
Not so late and not so great, right? And no longer called Townley. The years have not been terribly kind.
What's the end game, man? We had a good thing going without him.
If it's such a good thing, where's my money, huh? Where's my consultancy and my big fat dividend? I want a franchise network, Ron. I want reward cards and merchandise. I want to make gun violence and drug dependency accessible to every man and beast from Hove Beach to Vespucci. I want country clubs and a depressed wife with blonde hair and a hot little secretary who bounces on my boy.
There's Oscar's business. That's bringing cash in.
My stake in Oscar's thing ain't under the TP conglomerate umbrella. I want my own brand success.
It takes time.
Time and money. Sure, and Michael Townley, the Santa, the fuckface, is gonna give that to me. Just the plane I need to take on a heavily armed, tax-funded militia. Call our guys south of the border. Tell them there's a fire sale.
I'll get you on the radio.
On my 12.
You got the weapons they're using to enslave us on board. If we could get a hold of them, oh my god. I know it isn't my place to ask, but how exactly do you plan on requisitioning this equipment when you've caught up to them?
Whoa! One step at a time, Ronald. Let's just get there first.
Almost be dead, guys.
You know, the cargo plane's got four jets, a 200-foot wingspan.
Yeah. And I'm in a crop duster. This is something I'm acutely aware of. Enough. Again.
I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to have you back. We're a good team.
Every team needs a leader and a mindless follower or two.
That's right, boss.
Sir, they're what? Using these guns for a coup in West Africa? Protecting some mineral-rich warlord? Confiscating the weapons is practically a public service. Karmically, we're golden! What's not to be sure about?
When you put it like that...
Handle your end, okay?
He's low! Remember! Don't want to give him reason to think you're suspect!
Altitude's just fine, Ron.
How long is this
battle? All right, we're out of military airspace. Clear to gain altitude.
I'm just gonna ask.
All righty.
Come in, light aircraft. Identify yourself and state your intent.
Me? I'm just a lonely guy out dusting his crops. Who are you? Shoot me down? Now that's not very sociable.
Final warning! Divert or you will be grounded!
My fate's in your hands.
We are clear to engage!
What's wrong with you?
Oh, I almost flew into that one.
Grabbing me! Oh my good God!
Oh, that's awesome.
We got a cockpit in the cargo jet!
That's all. Up the ladder.
Jet to ground control, please be advised of a change of destination. We are now landing in Mackenzie Field. Changing frequency, over. Ron, you there? I got the jet. You with the buyers?
Welcoming parties here, Trevor. Fly safe now.
Oh, this is awesome. Oh no.
We're under orders to escort you to base. Change course or we will engage.
Or you could diddle yourself. Hey Ron, so the freaking Air Force are on me.
They deploy jets. Try and fly over them, T.
Fly above them. All right.
Any offensive action will be met with overwhelming retaliation.
Maybe I'll give you 10% of what's in the hole. Then we're all happy. should shoot me down anyway. Think of the ground casualties.
Authorization process complete. Clear to engage. Eagle 1, Fox 2. Eagle 2, Fox 2.
They shot me!
In the middle of the lake, I'm guessing I need to go there or something.
Fucking whatever.
Do I not need to go there?
Trevor! Shit, are you okay? I saw the plane go down.
I survived, and Lizard Army didn't do so well, so that's something.
Ah, thank God! The fuselage went into the Alamo Sea. You might be able to salvage the hardware with dive gear or something.
Ah, good idea! But it'll take time. Tell Oscar he ain't getting these guns.
Okay, look, I gotta ask. Are you in with the federal government? An agent, Sanchez, was round here saying you and Michael had to meet his supervisors at the garage, the cook site.
Fuck, I gotta do this, okay? But I'm using them, all right? They ain't using me. Let's make that clear. This ain't right. Don't you get, buddy?
Oh, damn it!
Die, asshole! Crap!
That's it. I'm dialing that one. You fucker.
We've got a civilian requiring assistance on, Panorama Drive.
Great! Police!
Not in this car, please, no.
Ram 2, we're kinda nearby.
Christ alive!
That doesn't make sense.
Oh, nice place you got here.
Oh, yeah. It's easy to mock, isn't it, huh? Cheap and fucking easy. But this here is my place. And my work paid for my place.
All right, relax. I was just being sarcastic.
Yeah, well, don't be, all right? Because the world doesn't need any more sarcasm. It's the blight of the age.
Yeah, I get the point.
You don't get the point. You're like every other asshole. You made a bit of money, and you became a turd.
Got news for you. I was always a turd.
No! You weren't, man. You were something. But now, man, you know, you're like this place. You're a shell.
Go fuck yourself. Are you some kind of pure morally justifiable asshole? What, because you're totally psychotic, somehow it's okay?
I'm honest, all right? You're the hypocrite.
Oh, yeah, you're a fucking hero. So far above it all.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm not above ripping open your fucking chest to see what's replaced your heart.
Rip it open. See what's there, baby, because I'm ready.
Hello? Oh, ladies, what's up?
Fuck off!
Listen. I'm sorry, but we've got a problem. Government funding thing. We need you to investigate a research lab upstate.
It's about terrorism, the big one, nerve gas, biological terror.
Thank God I don't pay tax.
Listen, you'll need some fairly standard gear. Boat, tandem rotor heavy lift helicopter, truck, weapons. You'll have to source all of that. Chopper alone will set you back a couple of mil.
Oh, no worries there. Trevor here, he just came into a lot of money.
Is that sarcasm?
Oh, you're fucking A right at sarcasm. You fuck. A few weeks ago, I was happily retired, sulking by my swimming pool. And my psychotic best friend shows up out of nowhere to torture me over mistakes I made, honest mistakes I made over a decade ago. We, our little posse, are flat fucking broke. But hey, let's go out and spend $2 million on a tandem rotor fucking chopper so I can go steal nerve gas from fucking terrorists. Forgive me, you ignorant fuck. But sarcasm is all I fucking got. Sarcasm and a room full of you cunts.
Yes!
Woo!
Welcome back, man. It is the old you.
Yeah. Well, we gotta go. It's been great, but Dave here's got a Pilates class. Now remember, ladies, you keep us way out of this thing. Bye-bye.
Ah, Jesus fucking Christ. All right, I'll give Lester a fucking call. He said he knew about something.
Now you tell him that we're driving towards Polito Bay.
Get in the car.
He went a long way around.
and Lester.
What now?
We got a funding problem. So we need a job. Before the jewel store, you talked about a score, a bank in the sticks. I need you to meet us there. Polito Bay, right?
That's the one. I'll get on a bus.
All right, Lester's meeting us there.
Oh, great.
Don't start.
No. Oh, no.
Come on. You're driving us up to the bank.
Again, really.
Let me call Lester.
Michael, how's your vacation?
Just great. Paradise. Only it's turning into a work trip. I remember you mentioning something about a bank in the sticks.
Uh-huh.
That wasn't Polito Bay by any chance.
That's the one.
All right, look. I'm heading there with Trevor. Can you get down here and help us scope it out?
Okay, sure. I'll get on a bus.
Oh, Lester's coming, so you know.
I don't mind cutting invalid in on a score we gotta give to the feds.
Yeah, well, there might be something in it for us, too. How much do they say they needed?
$2 million plus.
Oh, this Hayseed Bank, you gonna be carrying that kind of change?
Local law enforcement extort money from all the weed farms, whorehouses, meth kitchens in the area. They keep their cash in safe deposit boxes. Then there's all the normal small-town payroll stuff.
We should do well.
Us two on another bank. A bank? This is it, man. This is a comeback tour. It's gonna be a ride.
Yeah, by a ride. You mean you get to kill people, right? That's my Trevor. You love making a felony into felony murder, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. You're more of an aggravated murder kind of guy. Still ends with a death penalty.
If they catch you.
Then it's just that troubled conscience of yours.
I've learned to stop blaming me for me. You should try it sometime.
No, thank you.
Of course not. You're usually too obliterated to consider your actions with anything approaching deep thought.
Whoa, man. What happened to you? Maybe my friend did die that day.
What happened to me? Life happened, Trevor. Responsibility.
Oh, yeah, this again, please. You're part of the community now? What if your pals at the country club found out how you paid the membership fee?
I ain't that popular at the country club. But I'll tell you what, if they did know, they'd probably try to option my life story.
Oh, God, the stars in your eyes. Typical movie geek narcissist.
I'm not a narcissist.
Only narcissists care that much about their tan lines. You've got a sense of entitlement. You think the world owes you something. That's why you take scores. That's why you cut out on me and Brad for a life of empty luxury.
Oh, you're a therapist now, huh? Wake up, Trevor. You take scores too. You're as bad as me. What am I saying? There's no possible world in which you're as bad as me.
It's not the same.
What's not?
You got a condition. I have a coherent philosophy.
Oh, a philosophy? Really? Dude, you should have joined that midlife crisis motorcycle club you massacred, you douche.
Yeah, you'd know all about a midlife crisis.
Hey, your crisis started the day you were born. I'm just catching up.
Bus stops up here.
All right. How long does it take us to get out here from LS? Come on, man. Knock it off.
What?
I'm gonna break your fucking fingers. You don't knock that shit off.
Well, please, all right? You'd alleviate the boredom.
Ah, finally. Hey.
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 Welcome to paradise. Come on, car's this way.
Dry out here.
Don't worry, brother. Michael will take care of all your moisturizing needs. Oh. Shall we?
Might as well get started.
Okay, let's take a look at this bank. And we'll go to the front of the bank, clock the entrance. If the paperwork's correct, the alarm will be a relic. We should be in and out before the local PD knows what's happening.
You're calling it, sure.
That's the entrance to the bank. Nothing special. Take us around back.
Okay.
There's an empty lot behind. No one should pay attention to us back there.
It's not ideal. It's gonna cost more to break that system than the score's gonna pay.
Well, then we're gonna have to find a new score.
No. This is the score. What are our options?
It's a dumb idea, but we could trigger the alarm, see what kind of response they throw out.
That is a dumb idea.
Hey, you heard the man, all right? Shoot the sucker.
Okay, I brought my police scanner. Now drive over to the gas station opposite the bank, and we'll monitor chatter.
All right.
Alarm going off at Blaine County Savings Bank. All cars in the area, please respond.
Polito cars 3, 6, 9, and 1 will be there in 50 seconds.
Roger that. 4 units. Backup team at station is available.
They've dispatched 4 cars in 60 seconds and more on standby. And it isn't even 30 Victor or shots fired. Oh, this is a real headache.
What do you got on the clock?
40 seconds.
This is Polito Security. Any updates on the code 30, Adam? Backup ready to mobilize.
This is not normal. The response is out of proportion.
Cops in this county are dirty. And the alarm just went off on their piggy bank.
This is them. What is that, a 67-second response time?
Yeah, 4 cars. More in the wings.
Bad cops, guarding dirty money. Fuck how many? We can take this.
Wait right here. We'll see if anything about their routine suggests a weakness.
Polito Radio, this is Polito Car 3. We have a code 12, false alarm, possibly triggered intentionally.
Roger that. We're gonna set up checkpoints on the Great Ocean Highway and the Sonora Freeway. Car-to-car searches and record checks.
Checkpoints? Searches? Fuck this! I ain't getting caught because Lester needs a wheelchair.
Hey! Wheelchair or not, we're still faster than your ass!
Well, I'm not gonna outrun a cop. We've gotta go.
We're going. And if we're in front of Trevor, he'll be the one running through the cops.
I'm keeping you in my brain.
Is the correct driver? Are you sure? Why is he so fast in that car? Oh, please, please.
Jesus, what took you so long?
Had to let you win.
Set up a board over here.
Oh. Michael, man, your blood sugars are low. I'm making you some leftovers.
I'm fine, T.
Huh? No, I'm the host, man. You know, I don't want you to get hungry and moody, right? Then you're gonna be making the wrong decisions.
Man, I've been making wrong decisions my whole life. That's how I ended up here.
There you go. Bon appetito.
Jesus Christ, Trevor, what is that?
What's wrong with you? That's just a what? An eyelid. That's probably not even human. Unless that gas station job.
Gentlemen, some plans for your attention?
Oh, good. I'm gonna stay here a minute longer than I have to.
So I think our little experiment showed that the response will be too quick to beat and too strong to walk through. That means you gotta face the cops head on.
Dirty cops.
The dirty cops head on.
Head on? Man, I don't know.
Well, you'll be prepared. Convoys carrying military-grade hardware pass near here to get to Fort Zancudo. I propose hijacking one and using the equipment to get an edge on the locals. I can get you the exact details of the shipment as soon as we're done here. Anyway, you won't be outside the bank too long. Polito Bay is, well, it's a bay. So you're a street away from the water where Franklin can be waiting in a boat to get you out of there. I know none of this is ideal, but it's the only way I can see of taking the score and providing for your FIB paymasters.
Fine. We need personnel?
Just a gunman. He'll be taking on the cops with you, so my advice, choose someone good.
Think about my buddy's chef, okay? Consummate professional.
You sure this is the guy?
That should do.
I'll get the equipment together. Michael, you reach out to Franklin. Trevor, you do what you do.
Roger that.
I'll call you when we're ready to move on this.
You want to bunk with us? I mean, it's going to be tight, but, you know, mi casa, su casa.
I'll get a motel, thanks.
All right, suit yourself.
Come on, I'll give you a ride.
Okay. Adios, amigos.
Franklin, buddy, what's up?
Hey, look, there's these redneck dudes been looking for you, homie. Some angry motherfuckers. I found where they stay, man, and I've been following them.
Okay, well, it's gotta be the O'Neill brothers. What's left of them. I'll pick up Michael and we'll come to you.
T, hey, man.
I've been thinking about it. I'm not quite sure if I'm ready to accept an apology.
Where is my wife?
Patricia doesn't want to speak to you. Frankly, neither do I.
I will find you!
Okay. Well, I'll put some coffee on then. I'll see you soon.
Can I get him out of the couple?
Hey, come to the potluck supper tomorrow night.
Okay. I'm gonna stop it there.